Morning all. Yes, it's that time again where we get together and have a little play with our knobs because it is video view time and I've got a couple of special guests as usual who will give their views on a great stack of videos that we got lined up for you tonight. First up, a guy who's currently sitting very pretty at number 2 in the network chart, Bomb the Bass, it's Tim Simonon. Good morning.
Hello.
You all right?
Yeah, fine.
Very nice hat you got on there and all.
Yeah,
very, very natty as well. And to my right, a guy who will be at Hammersmith Odeon tonight.
That's right.
Zodiac Mindwarp, good morning.
Good morning.
And are you looking forward to the big one tonight?
Yes, I'm looking forward to treading the boards tonight.
Good,
yes.
So as soon as you've done this, home to a bit of kip, all right? Because you've got to be on there tonight. Right, first up tonight then, let's get these videos on the road. It's a video which cost a mere 50,000 quid. It was filmed in Jordan. In fact, it's the first ever video to be shot over there. Sisters of Mercy, their new single, it's Dominion. Good sound. Hello. He likes that
sound.
Doesn't
work.
You good. You're in there. Directed by David Hogan, the guy who directed Prince's You Got the Look. Very stunning. Sisters of Mercy. Tim, what do you rate on that one?
Yeah, it's good. I like that. It's a good video as well. Expensive.
Mm-hmm. Well, it says 50,000 quid, and apparently there were 60 camels and 37 horses in that. And that, believe it or not, cost a lot less than the video for their last single, which was made in London. So obviously the camels come very cheap out there. So yeah.
Just buy them a bag of hay or something. You have to pay all these people in England, you know. I thought that was great, by the way.
Like a feature film, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was like The Omen. I thought it was great.
There's a bit like
The Omen. Yeah. It looks like he's searching for dangerous drugs and Arab boys, you know.
Is that the kind of video that you'd be eagerly looking out for on TV again to spot something you missed, perhaps, you know, tonight?
I really like the Simon. I just like the. I can watch all of it. I don't like knobbing them off, you know. I want to see more. I like all kinds of videos, but I thought that was, you know, 50 grand. It was a good one.
Yeah. Apparently, they reckon when they decided to do it out in Jordan, they you know, because of the troubles out there, they decided to ask the government, and the government said, ah, don't worry, where you're going, it's a good day's tank ride from where the troubles are. Anyway, next up, we've got a group of Mancunians who get their inspiration from the American soul greats of the 60s and 70s, Mick Hucknall and the Boys, Simply Red with I Won't Feel Bad. I always tend to think those type of videos are a bit of a cop-out, don't you? You know, just to get a bit of the group on stage and then follow them around the street with the old camera and cut it together in a relatively cheapo video there. So, what do you reckon on that one?
What Mick Hucknall did on his holidays, you know, might not make him feel bad, it makes me feel pretty bad, but I think it's... It's kind of, you know, I mean, here he is on a stage, you know, he's not doing particularly much, but... And I don't like his haircut either, anyway.
No, he's had that for a while, hasn't he? Well, you say that you like watching lots of videos and that. Well, what would be your kind of fave video? What do you look for, then? What?
Funny stuff and, you know, good-looking girls and lots of action and fast edits and bombs going off and explosions and fire and, you know...
Right.
Cartoons and not... Some guy with a carrot head, you know, dancing around.
Because, Tim, the video for...
Bomb the Bass.
Bomb the Bass, which we showed, which was number 1 on the dance chart last night in Chart Attack, is roughly, I think, what Zodiac kind of likes, the kind of fast
edits.
Cutting, yeah. Did you do that? Do you have any say in
that? Well, I mean, I sort of chose all the locations and sort of, like, not directed it, but sort of gave some idea of how I wanted it, just to go with the song, really, you know.
So that Simply Red one, does that do anything for you at all?
No, I didn't really like the video, but he's got a good voice, you know.
Yeah,
he's got an horrible voice.
I thought it was quite a funky song, actually.
Yeah, the white voice.
No, I mean the video is
flying soul.
Hey,
what's he say?
A walking stick, yes, you know.
Oh yeah.
Now here is a real hot rocking guy, ex-Van Halen frontman David Lee Roth. Now this is a single taken from the mega-selling Skyscraper LP. This is Just Like Paradise. Get a load of this.
For me, go hang on tight, don't let go. This must
4 years since David Lee Roth was with Van Halen, and he's back, and that is a real smash hit single on the cards there. Tim, does like heavy metal stuff like that or rock music like that do anything for you?
Yeah, I used to be really into heavy metal when I was little. Yeah, it's a good guitar breaker now, actually. Use that on the next record. Yeah.
You will?
Yeah.
Oh, you've got it already. Have you got a tape recorder in his pocket already?
Sampled it,
What about that video? I mean, it was actually him there, wasn't it? Hanging around up in the the heights off that mountain?
Yeah, I mean, it's just like another sort of, another rock, typical rock American sort of video, isn't it? On stage and...
I always find, Zodiac, look, especially when we do the heavy metal chart on Chart Attack, that lots of those type of videos are always very entertaining. Even if perhaps you don't like the record, you can always kind of look for different funny pieces in those.
He's one of the best in the world, Dave Lee Roth, and he can climb mountains as well, you know what I mean? I don't know about his tailor, you know, the Alibaba trousers, I think.
He's making a big comeback, apparently, this year, Alibaba. Flares and platforms this year.
No, I think all Van Halen into them Alibaba trousers, they all wear them, you know, they kind of... And no, I like that. I like. I think Dave is great. He's one of the best.
And that made you smile, that one?
Yeah, Tokyo Rose or something, that was better. There was more kind of like guitars and stuff. It's a bit mellow, that song. You know? Mm-hmm. I prefer more screaming, wheeling guitars, you know?
Right. All right. Well, from squealing, wheeling guitars, now up on our video Wheels of Steel, it's single number 5 from Johnny Hates Jazz, taken from the number 1 selling long player Turn Back the Clock. This is their current 45, Heart of Gold. Johnny Hates Jazz and Heart of Gold, and a pretty nifty bit of footwork up to the knobbing off button there. Zodiac, you didn't like that one?
No, it looked like you put something in my tea. It was making me go dizzy, all the picture, you know.
It's the jiggery-pokery in the studio, by the looks of it.
Yeah, I think the director's looked at some David Hockney Polaroids, you know. He's kind of weirded me out. No, I didn't like that one. The song was kind of a bit fretless bass as well.
Have you liked any of their stuff? Johnny Hates Jazz, or is it just...
Well, it's just one of those groups that kind of, you know, trickle out the radio and you sort of go to the toilet.
Make it into the top 40, yeah.
I'm sure they're very nice chaps, aren't they, you know?
Are you sure? Right, Tim,
yeah,
then.
They are. They're like me, you see. They said they like my video, so I feel a bit mean now.
Yeah. Go on, then. Tim, what do you reckon on that one?
I mean, it'll be destined to be in the top 20, you know. It's just a...
Not something you can nick off that one, you never know.
I doubt it. No, not on that one.
The Robin Hood of pop over here. Right, they're off to the States soon, Johnny Hates Jazz. So, good. Thanks for the moment to Zodiac and to Tim. Coming very soon, we have a record which has actually been revitalised, the label for it. It's the new one from Morrissey. You'll get that in a couple of seconds right here. View on Night Network, Batman is on his way, but first up, some more vids. Now, for the next record, as I was saying, EMI actually revitalised the old HMV record label, you know, the one with the dog and the horn. Well, anyway, here's the old Smith with a new solo single, Morrissey and Suedehead. Morrissey's new one there, and Suedehead. Now, it's a I'm just going to spring this on you. That, the HMV record label there, what was the last single that was on HMV? Ha! Now, that's got you, hasn't it?
I ain't got a clue.
No idea. Believe it or not, right? It was the comedy actress called Joyce Grenfell. This is 20 years ago, and it was called I Wouldn't Go Back to the World I Know. So you can tell that to your mates down the pub tomorrow. Right, Tim?
I found it quite a morbid kind of video, actually. I suppose the best bit was when he was on the tractor. That was quite moving, yeah.
It was moving, yeah. It was going quite slow, though. Zodiac?
No, I like Morrissey. I mean, I think he's the nearest thing in England we've got to Michael Jackson, you know? I mean, he's, like, totally wacko, you know? With his tractors and things, you know? I like it. I think he's really funny.
I always used to think that the Smiths made great kind of 2.5-minute singles. You know, very simple, very thank you very much.
Has he got a monkey, you know?
Oh, Morrissey?
Yeah.
No, I think the rest of the group kind of left, I think. Pardon?
He's probably got a hamster, you know, that dresses up in James Dean clothes.
But you liked that one, didn't you? That is one of your...
I'm a big fan of Morrissey. I think he's really funny and clever. And I've liked all his records, you know. James? You know, sometimes I feel too happy, you know, I mean, I have to sort of bring myself down a bit.
You can't keep dancing to all their records, can you? Tim, big fan of James Dean?
Not really James Dean, but yeah, I used to like the Smiths, yeah.
When you were little, you know, when you liked heavy metal.
When he was home. All right, this is single number 2 for The Voice of America. Follow-up to Story of Love. They've been globe-trotting around the world for a while, but here's the new record offering, I Will Tell. Certainly will. Well, I thought I'd give that a chance to do something. Didn't really get going, as far as I'm concerned there, Tim.
Not really, no. Just found it really meaningful, you know, I couldn't really understand it. It's too meaningful, I think.
Not much of a story,
not really,
is it?
No, no.
A lot of tramps wandering around the street and things.
Anything you could do to have made that video any better then, Zodiac?
Yeah, I would have had a few of the tramps blowing up, I think, yeah.
Yeah, and some girls coming
up. Yeah, some fire, yeah. Bung a few boilers wandering around with no clothes on and stuff and set them on fire and stuff, you know.
Oh, well, I think we might as well just get on to the next one, don't you? Mm-hmm. Not too much to be said about that one, I'm afraid. Now it's two original real-life EastEnders, Mel and Kim, the Appleby girls from Hackney. Mixed and written, as usual, by Stock Aitken and Waterman, this is their new single, steaming up the chart, That's the Way It Is. Now, some people might think I'm thick, but I don't think Mel and Kim were in that, were they?
That's the way Lock, Stock and Barrel work with it, isn't it? Don't even bother having them in the video.
Well, I mean, I think they could have perhaps used some, you know, even used some old footage of the girls or even pictures or something in there, because they just, I don't know.
Well, it's going to be number one anyway. Yeah, definitely. You didn't have to put a video out, really. You know.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, people do like Mel and Kim, and so even if they just flashed a few pictures up, it would have been okay, wouldn't it? Do you not reckon, Tim? Just have them in there. I mean, at least have them in there somewhere.
Could have had her in a wheelchair, you know, whizzing around and things.
No, she's getting better, apparently, so the two girls will be back on the road very soon. So, Tim, go on, what do you reckon?
Not really, sort of my... Not really my cup of tea, really.
Not your cup of tea?
No.
But what would you, you know, what could you have done? I mean, put yourself in making videos now. What would you have done with that? Bearing in mind the girls, you know, one of them is ill at the moment, couldn't actually be there. What would you have done to that?
Put Stock Aitken and Waterman in the video, get them dancing, or dressed up as Mel and Kim.
Yeah?
Yeah, that would have been quite good, yeah.
Dare I ask, Zadek, what you would have done?
I would have had the shots of her in a wheelchair, you know, kind of like with her crutches and things and stuff. Fast edits in the hospital, you know.
Any explosions?
Yeah, I have the nurses blowing up. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Well, that's about it for Video View. Thank you, lads. Thanks, Tim. Good luck. Perhaps, possibly, Bomb the Base will be number one later on today on the network chart. You never know.
Never know.
Thanks a lot for being on. And Zodiac, thanks a lot for coming in. Good luck at Hammersmith Odeon tonight.
You can ask me my favourite one.
Yeah, what's your favourite one?
Sisters of Mercy.
All right. All right, Tim, quickly, what's your favourite?
Mel and Kim.
Mel and Kim. Oh. All right, then, thank you very much. Still to come, lots and lots. Tonight we've got some more live Jonathan Butler. Batman Adam West is here. Yes, he's on his way. Harry Stavros Enfield in Pillow Talk with Emma. And very, very soon, hey, it's the Partridge Family. I'll see you next week. Ta-da.